Oh, hey there. I was listening to my favorite style of music. Classical music. Anyways, I found this really great song on the internet. FBI! So, what I was thinking about while thinking about songs and all of that was this passage in this book called The Song of Songs. Now, many people think that the book Song of Songs, or Songs of Solomon, depending on what translation of the Bible you have, is this book that you read in secret when you're a teen and you don't talk about it with your parents and whatever. But I think that's just simply not true. But before we go to that book, I want us to turn to the book of Revelation, which is the very last book of the Bible. Revelation 3, verse 20, says this. Here I am. I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come in and eat with him, and he with me. See, I've heard this Bible verse shared and preached as though this is for unbelievers, for people who aren't Christians. Well, I have a hard time believing that, because in this passage, Jesus is talking to his church. He's talking to Christians, people who are believers. And he says that when he knocks at the door of your heart, that we're to answer and to respond. And that there are people who don't respond. It's one of the accusations he makes against one of the churches that he speaks of in the book of Revelation. But here's where the book Song of Songs comes in. It says this in Song of Songs, chapter 5, verse 2. I slept, but my heart was awake. Listen, my lover is knocking. And he says, open to me, my sister, my darling, my dove, my flawless one. My head is drenched with dew, my hair with the dampness of night. Now you might ask yourself, what does this have to do with anything? Well, this is a passage of a bride listening and waiting for her husband to arrive. And it's something interesting, because the church is described as the bride of Christ. And it says here that the bride's position to the husband is to wait and to know the voice of her husband so that when he arrives, she knows that it is him. And so for us, we are to recognize the voice of our Father. We're to recognize the voice of Christ when he calls out to us. When we read the word, when we go in prayer and we think about all these things that he said to us and that we feel his guidance, we need to recognize that. Because it says that those who are Christ will respond and are expecting Christ to show up and to make himself known to them. And so this week, as you take time to pray and you take time to seek God, I pray that the desire of your heart would be to listen more attentively, to hear his voice, to hear his guiding for your life. That you wouldn't be caught by surprise when he knocks and says, I need you to do this. I'm calling you to that. That you wouldn't be shocked, because you would be waiting expectantly that God would come through for you. And so I just pray and hope and desire for you that you will go deeper and deeper into the knowledge of his voice. And on that note, God bless.